forward and a backslash and a keyboard. Yes, I know, Murph. On the Hogsback, I know that. But it's always forward slashing. And internet addresses is now. I think that's what we're saying. Is that right, Murph?
I think it is always forward slash.
Is it a reverse slash anywhere?
No.
Chris, in the pop quiz last night, we found out that owls are the only birds that can see blue. My question is, how do they know, says Malkin Duckfield.
Online, on digital radio, and on 88 and 91 FM.
BBC News at 1 o'clock. This is Fenella Fudge. The economy grew by just under 1% last year, but shrank in the final quarter. Ministers have lost their legal battle to accelerate a cut in subsidies for solar electricity. Measures are being taken to stop protesters occupying sites at the Olympic Games. The economy is performing worse than expected, down 0.2% in the final 3 months of 2011. A big drop in output from manufacturers is given as the main cause. The Chancellor, George Osborne, said Britain's economic problems weren't helped by the debt crisis in Europe.
Britain has substantial economic problems and debt built up over the last 10 years, but dealing with those problems is made more difficult by the situation in the Eurozone. What's happening at home is also affected by what's happening abroad.
But the Shadow Chancellor, Ed Balls, accused...
Michelle's nephew. The Roux family are synonymous with fine cuisine, and now, for the first time, Albert Roux, Michel Roux Sr., Alain Roux, and Michel Roux Jr. will be seen working and cooking alongside each other on television. So we have Michel and Michelle here. So which one is which, guys?
I don't know anymore.
I'm the young one.
Oh, are you? Yeah. Oh, yes, so you are. Oh, wait a minute, I can't quite...
He's the marathon one.
Yes, so he is, yeah.
I get the compliment, I get the email. Well done, if you should stop sometimes. And he's the one who is doing it.
That's brilliant. My first question is actually rather unusually about snails. And I was just asking Michel Roux Jr., surely people don't really eat snails. And you said, well, that's what...
And I learned on Stargazing Live that the seas of the moon are actually volcanic plateaus, mm-hmm. which I didn't know before. And we can actually see the individual craters. I have never properly applied myself to saying, okay, well, where's the North Star?
Mm, exactly.
How do you find the way from that?
And so you can find your way home.
Well, yes.
But there's a far cut.
Yes.
But there is so much out there. And as you said, you know, it is a learning experience, but at the same time, it's entertainment value as well, really, isn't it? Because you're bringing the whole family along.
Absolutely. And you know, the other thing for me about this is that the people who will be coming and talking to us on these subjects are absolute top-class experts in their field, not just in Northern Ireland, but you're talking about internationally. Like, the Armagh Planetarium, for example, is internationally renowned. It draws people from around the world to go and study there. We have some of those students present on Friday night as well. So, you know, we've got a guy who's going to talk to us. He's going to tell you what it's made of, how long it's going to last. You know, and just think of it this way. You know, the sun up there, all that distance away, far bigger than Earth, so hot, and yet it can ripen grapes in Italy, just like it's, that's what it was there to
I'm
do.
Going to ask you a question.
Yes.
Which planet is the most visible to the naked eye?
Which planet? I don't know. That's a great one for your listeners, mm-hmm. is it not?
Yeah.
I mean, and again, I think I think it's either very stupid or very brave of me to come in here and show how absolutely ill-equipped I am to talk about it. But that's the beauty of it.
Fantastic.
I'm looking forward to learning. That's
exactly. Surround yourself by experts. Exactly. But you mentioned there, do us a favour. Would you ring some of these experts and find out if I'm just going to be standing like an agent at Dunluce Castle this evening at half 11, staring.